Let's head to the Pacific Islands, where Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi's diplomatic tour continues. Mr Yi has held talks with counterparts from 10 Pacific Island nations in Fiji, many attending virtually, discussing proposals for Beijing to radically increase its involvement in the security, economy and politics of the South Pacific. Samoa's already signed a bilateral agreement with China, but other nations are wary. For more, we're joined by Fiji's Social Democratic Liberal Party leader, Bill Gavoka. Nisa Yandra, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Bill. We've been talking around the situation that's been happening in the Pacific, but actually to have somebody within the Fijian government, within the government, it's an honour. So thank you so much for your presence this morning. What do you make of the Chinese Foreign Minister Wang Yi's visit to the Pacific?
Okay, thank you for having me this morning. I must say that I agree totally with the consensus by the 10 island nations of the Pacific not to get into the trade agreement and the security agreement with China. There's much to be done. There is a lot of anxiety within the Pacific community on this relationship with China, given the current geopolitical situation in the Northern Pacific. China is becoming very assertive, and we are not very comfortable with what it could lead to, as most of us, Fiji in particular, and my party in particular, wants to stay closely in matters of security with our big neighbors, Australia and New Zealand, our traditional allies, and the United States. So there is quite a lot of anxiety having China in our neighborhood.
So can you expand on what that anxiety is around? I mean, their presence and what they were proposing has been described as aggressive. You've said that there's concern around what further influence of China, what it could lead to. So talk me through what you mean by that and where specifically the anxiety and concern is with an increasing presence and influence of China in the Pacific.
Well, for one, we've been watching the development in the Solomon Islands, and we are not really comfortable with that. We want to maintain our police force and our military all within our region and tied to our traditional allies. There is data communications that is also very can be used in other areas, especially in defense systems. So really, we have a very peaceful region, And when we see the tensions in the other part of the Pacific, in the northern part of the Pacific, we really don't want that in our area. We really want to stay as we are, with our traditional allies. That's basically what it is. We're not comfortable with the way China is approaching the Pacific, especially in terms of security.
What then do you make of, and I'm not sure whether you're keen to comment on this, but were you surprised by Samoan Prime Minister Viliame Naomi Mataafa's economical and technical cooperation agreement that was signed over the weekend with China?
Yes, we were surprised. Let me just say this, that China is the second biggest economy in the world. We cannot ignore that. And they have done some good work in Fiji and in the Pacific Island countries. But security and data communication is something else. And we'd like to keep that very much intact within the current arrangements that we've had over the years. So that's where it is. In all areas, economic superpower, we want to engage with them. Security matters, no, definitely no.
What about when it comes to the economy? Because we know that Fiji was hit hard by the pandemic. Now, China can woo you on an economic basis in terms of money that they can pump into the economy there, but also around climate change. Are those some of the things that you would be happy to look at when it comes to any agreement with China?
There are specific areas where we can work with China. It has been there for quite some time. So, I mean, like you, we adopted the One China policy back in the days of Richard Nixon when he opened up China. I mean, he opened up the relationship with China. And we pretty much kept it that way on specific programs. We have a relationship with Taiwan, and people around the region. It's on a specific case by case basis, as opposed to totally opening up, and especially in areas of security. That is where we draw the line.
Can I ask you about New Zealand's response to China's foreign minister being in the Pacific? We know that Australia's new foreign minister visited there last week. Our minister is waiting for the Pacific Forum, which is to take place in July. We know that our Pacific Minister and Associate Foreign Minister Apito William Seo is getting on a plane today to head to Fiji. But how do you feel New Zealand has responded to what is happening with China's visit in the Pacific?
We expected a sense of heightened activities in the area with a superpower in our neighborhood. We had a very successful meeting, a visit from the Australian Foreign Minister, reassuring us of the support. And we know that both New Zealand and Australia came out very strongly in support of Fiji during the pandemic. I mean, you came out in a very big way. A small country like Fiji with limited resources, you made a big difference for us. And that is not a one-off thing. It has always been there. And we want to keep it that way. And China has helped. But again, I say, on a case-by-case basis with them, not won't refuse anything to do with education or health or climate change. But in totality, the relationship to include the security, no. We want to keep with our traditional allies, which are our big neighbors and the Commonwealth and the USA.
Yeah, I think you've made that pretty clear this morning. Thank you so much for your time. Bill Gavoka, Social Democratic Liberal Party leader, joining us from Fiji. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Okay, thank you. Thank you for having me.